Merry Christmas, baby. You sure did treat me nice. Merry Christmas, pretty baby.
Hi, my name is Dr. Phalese Binion, and I'm the CEO and President of the Westside Ministers Coalition. Right now, we are so blessed to be able to take families down to Danville Correctional Center so that we can have Christmas before Christmas. I want to give a shout out to the Congressman and all the hard work that he's done in the Second Chance, and how we are all coming together and galvanizing to be able to go down and take these kids, their mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, just to come down to have a Christmas feast. The kids are going to be doing a spoken word and contests and coloring, and there's going to be gifts and laughter and joy and happiness, which is what this season is all about. It's what Christmas is about. This is the epitome of what Christmas is. Being able to love on one another, glean on one another, share with one another, and be happy and have good times and fond memories. So we thank you, and as you leave and see all of the other things that we're going to be doing today, hopefully, prayerfully, next year, you might want to come and be a part of it and be a part of it.
My name is Joseph Green. I'm here with the Congressman to celebrate this event, celebrating Christmas, where we bring in hope, but we also bring in empowering information and resources to the families on this bus and also to the people that we're going to see. So it's going to be a huge event. I'm just very thankful and blessed to be a part of it. And I'm thankful that the families were able to come, because it was not easy for everybody to pull it together. But it just shows when we come together, we can really make a difference. So the work is still, we got a lot of work to do, but I'm just very happy and blessed to be a part of this. Thank you.
We're here this morning taking families up to be with their loved ones at Danville Correctional Institution. This is the first of this type of program where we're able to let fathers mingle with their children. And so we're really excited about this, because what we believe is that this will open up opportunities for more institutions to have the same interaction with their children, because we understand children need their fathers, and we want to do everything we can to advocate and see how we can make that happen even while they're incarcerated, because we know for a fact that if a man is incarcerated, he gets a chance to have a relationship with his child or children, he becomes a better man, and the children become better children. So we're really excited about this, and we're looking forward to what the future brings, but more so we're looking for what today brings.
Hi, my name is Danville